Hey all, welcome back to my channel. And today's video we're going to see how to apply a foundation. I'm going to tell you what you should apply before a foundation, after a foundation, how to apply it, and which tools you're supposed to be using. So if you want to watch this video, then let's get started. So first step, you have to cleanse your face. I've used the biotic cleanser to cleanse my face already, and now I'm going to apply a toner. I have kind of huge pores on my face, so I just want to close them up. So I'm using the Bio Cucumber Pore Tightening Toner. So you can take a cotton pad like this and apply it all over your face. I kind of look really tired because I had a very rough day in the morning, and so once this step is over, I'm going to go ahead and apply a moisturizer. Moisturizer can be any moisturizer of your choice. Whichever skin type you have, you can choose a moisturizer according to your wish. Once we apply the moisturizer, we're going to apply the primer. So I'm going to use the Nilgiri Shea Butter Daily Moisturizer a little bit. I'm going to be doing one side of the foundation, one side of my face, the foundation, so that you can see what difference it makes to my face. My skin type is combination skin type. I just get oily on my T-zone, around my nose and all that, but not totally oily. Now that I'm done with the step, I'm going to go ahead and apply a primer. So you can apply any primer of your choice. I'm applying a silicone based primer. This is from Colourbar. So since I don't need primer all over my face, just to cover the pores around my nose area, a little bit over here, and the T-zone where I usually get very oily. So I'm going to go ahead and apply my primer only on those areas. Makes the foundation glide on very smoothly. So as you can see, I'm only putting it on the areas that is required, not totally. Step is the foundation. So one thing that you have to keep in mind is that the brush gives a better coverage no matter what type of foundation you're going to use. And a sponge, if you're going to use a sponge with a liquid foundation, it's going to suck up all the product and you will not get, you know, much of the product on your face. So you can use any foundation of your choice. I'm using the NYX Total Control Drop Foundation, and I will leave all the details in my description box or you can check it out. Now I'll be doing half side of the face to show you how it looks with the foundation, okay? I'm using a foundation flat brush like this to blend my foundation into the skin. I love this foundation because it gives you like skin-like finish. I also love to use foundation with the beauty blender, but not this foundation. If the consistency is a little bit thicker, like a cream, I prefer using a beauty blender. So I've used 4 drops of this foundation on one side of my face. As you can clearly see, it has made my skin even. And note that you should not be applying a foundation like this under your eyes. It's a little bit too, it's okay to cover it a little bit, but then this place will be covered with your concealer, so you can just leave out that place. Next step, I'm going to go ahead and put a concealer. When you choose a concealer, you should not be very, very light. People of my skin tone should not be using a concealer in the banana shade, okay? Just should be 2 to 3 tones lighter. I'm going to be using the Makeup Revolution Pro HD Cream Contour Palette that has concealers of different shades. I'm going to be using this shade right here. I think this palette is a very good palette, affordable one. You can use a brush to apply it as well, but I think my hand does a better job at it. You can go ahead and apply the same concealer above your eyes as well. Now the whole part of your eye looks very bright. If you have any dark spots in your face that you want to cover, you can use an orange corrector to correct it initially and then apply the foundation. I do not have any such dark spots, so I directly went on with my primer and the foundation. When you're applying a foundation, if you have corrected your skin, color corrected your skin, then in that case, you should be very careful not to disturb the orange corrector beneath your foundation, otherwise your foundation is going to look orangey. The best way is to buff the foundation in, not to just, you know, apply it in such a way that it'll move the concealer or your orange corrector beneath. So I have done half of my face and I'm very, very sure that you guys can see the difference clearly, that half my face is even toned and bright. I don't like putting too much foundation. I prefer light to medium coverage, so hence you can see the difference. This is how my face looks after the full makeup is done. I've not done anything big. I've just applied some eyeliner, some kajal and some lipstick. So if you guys like this video, please do share it with your friends and don't forget to subscribe for more such content. Thank you and see you in my next video. Bye bye.